What's up to whoever might be watching? My name's Justine. In today's video, I am going to be reacting to Juice WRLD's new album that is called Fighting Demons. If you're new to my channel and haven't seen, I actually have already reacted to three of the singles that were released off this project. I reacted to Burn with the music video, Already Dead, and Wander to LA featuring Justin Bieber. I will leave those three videos linked in the description in case you haven't seen them. But for this video today, I'm going to be reacting to the rest of the songs that were released on the album. That is pretty much what today's video is going to be. If you want to listen along with me, then just keep on watching. Already Dead and Burn were both like super emotional songs. Actually, those are the first two songs in the album. So it goes Burn, Already Dead. So the track that I'm going to start off with today is going to be You Wouldn't Understand. I'm just nervous because I'm filming this kind of late and I'm like, oh my gosh, this is gonna hit me so hard in the heart. I love Juice. I've heard great things about this album, so I'm really excited to dive on in. Let's go ahead and listen to You Wouldn't Understand.
What you don't understand about me is I never gave a fuck about a goddamn thing. I wake up in the morning, do my goddamn thing.
The way that he just flowed on this song especially, I like his rapping and then his fast rapping and then his singing. I really like this one. This one right off the bat is like super nice to the ears. I especially like where he says, I'm gonna live my life like it's my last days. Juice definitely had that mentality. Next song would be Wander to LA featuring Justin Bieber, but like I said, I've reacted to that already. So it looks like the next song that's on the project is called Eminem Speaks.
I think once I took my first Vicodin, it was just like this feeling of, you know, like everything was not only mellow, but didn't feel any pain. It just kind of numbed things. I don't know at what point exactly it started to be a problem. I just remember liking it more and more. People tried to tell me that I had a problem. I would say, get that fucking person out of here. I can't believe they said that shit to me. They know nothing about my fucking life. They out of fucking mind. Not out there shooting heroin. I'm not out there fucking, you know, putting coke up my nose. I'm not smoking crack. You're struggling with the argument of, do you have a problem or do you not have a problem? Can you control it or can you not? And I literally thought I could control it. It's been a learning process. Like it's been, I'm growing. I just couldn't believe that anybody could ever be naturally happy or naturally function or be just enjoying life in general without being on something. So I would say that to anybody, it does get better. You know, it does.
I know that Eminem was one of Juice's favorite rapper, if not his favorite rapper. I know he was a big inspiration and influence to him. So the fact that Eminem is on this album is just insane. Obviously, with the situation that Eminem is speaking on, and obviously that is the same kind of situation that Juice was going through with like the drugs and the depression and not feeling like you can be happy without taking any sort of substance. I think it's important for those types of issues to be talked about and not to be looked at like, yeah, they are scary topics, but just because it's like a hard thing to talk about doesn't mean we should avoid talking about it. Definitely like the ending too, how it ends on a positive note that, you know, Em just reminds you that things do get better and you can get help. It's amazing the respect that Juice obviously had for M, and then in return that M has for Juice. I'm really happy they were able to incorporate that. Next song is called Rockstar in His Prime.
I'm a rockstar in his prime. If I take too many perks, then I won't die. I make no sense, dude.
I take too many perks, then I won't die. If I drink too much of this syrup, then I won't fly. I'm a rock star in his prime. 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 Too high to talk right now, I'm sorry, beg my pardon. It's not a trend, it's how I'ma deal with my demons regardless. He's sitting right over there, telling me I should be scared. God in my fucking head, tell me it's nothing to fear. I forgot to mention that the devil trying to be my friend. Do you hear how confusing this is? I was at the lowest of points, feeling like calling it quits. Ain't nobody understand. You should be happy, nigga, you rich. That's what everybody says. Anxiety's an ugly bitch, too ugly to comprehend. So I get high and fuck that bitch. Praying for the upper hand, I hope that he hear my prayers. Devil really want my soul, he gon' keep it in his lair. Me, I'm just gon' keep a pole, paranoia in the air.
Wow, this one especially, his voice sounds amazing on. Basing off just a first listen, I think this is probably my favorite song that I've heard off this project so far. Ain't nobody understand, you should be happy, you rich. That's what everybody says, anxiety is an ugly bitch, too ugly to comprehend. As someone who struggles with anxiety, I 1000% understand where he's coming from. Obviously, I'm not rich, so I don't get that part of it. Just the whole you should be happy line, I definitely understand that, because especially when from an outsider's perspective, they look at you or they look at your life and they just automatically assume you don't have any problems or you should be happy or like surface level, everything looks like it's going great. Mental health is definitely something that can take a huge toll on you. Especially anxiety is such an ugly, ugly thing. Like I've said before, lyrics like this, even though they are deep and dark, it's comforting knowing that you're not alone in your struggles. I really think it's nice to bring light to these things and to let people know that they're not alone and to let people know that even the most successful people can struggle. Next song is called Doom.
No, I can't be fooled. I ain't playing by your rules. I'm known to lose my cool, but that's cool, cause I'm known to be too cool. There's a room full of toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. I'd rather me die before she, so I mix drugs up, trying to find my doom, trying to find my doom. Don't, I have a lot of troubles. I admit I'm running from walking through Hollywood. I admit I'm astonished. So much has happened in the last few months. Broke to rich, I'm falling in love again. I said so much has happened in the last 3 months. Drugs to mix, so I'll pick up the phone no more.
I definitely like how he talks about his life and his journey in this song. He's definitely one of like the best artists in my opinion when it comes to like telling his story through his music. I feel like everything that he talks about is just so true and genuine to his life and his experiences and what he's going through. I like that one a lot. Next song is called Go Hard.
Drugs hard. Smoking on dough like a rock star. Try to take you from an edge, I'ma go grah grah. Go, go, they go grah grah. Go, try to take you from me, they go grah grah. Go, go, they go grah grah. Go, go, go. I was sitting in the crib with a handful of racks and a heart full of pain. Yeah, funny thing is, I really did think I was the same. Then I saw your face and I heard your name. Had to make you my babe, put that on the gang gang. The groupie hoes don't faze me, tryna get back their lane brain, it don't amaze me. Your heart, I
back in 10-10. Take it to safety.
Yeah,
you're my getaway. So you can get away.
Before you, I go hard, hard. Just don't break my heart, hard.
Just don't break my heart.
I've been on the drugs hard, hard.
I've been on the drugs hard.
Smoking on dough like a rock star. Try to take you from this, I'ma go grind, grind.
This track is really refreshing in a way. It has a different kind of feel than the other songs that I've listened to on the album so far. I definitely like this one too, and I think it's like a cute song towards his girl. Side note, something I just want to say that I forgot to say at the beginning. I know that some of these songs have been leaked or people have heard them already. I personally don't listen to leaks. I haven't heard any of the songs on the album so far. So these are genuine, like, first real reactions. Juice WRLD speaks.
I never really had nothing to hide. Like, it was never really no filter in my head. Like, would it be not cool to talk about your emotions? You know, like, it was never nothing in my conscience, in my head to tell me not to do that. Going through some music not only is something that kind of helps the situation pass, I also make music talking about certain subjects because I know that I'm not the only one going through, you know, what's happening. Me talking about certain things can help somebody else through what they're going through, as well as me trying to figure it out myself.
You know, you tell your mom, your dad, your auntie, whoever, that you feel like you got anxiety, you feel like you got depression, you feel like you got ADD, whatever. They don't look at you like you're crazy.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't got that. Get out of here. Like, are you gonna tell me I don't got something? You know, that's not how it should be. But that's how it is, and that needs to change. And hopefully, I'm one of those people that could bring that change.
I love that they're incorporating his message that he wants to put out. I 100% agree with what he's saying, where he said like people will kind of tell you like, oh no, you don't have that, or especially like people from older generations, even like my parents, they don't really understand anxiety. They don't really understand like what it is I go through. I'm 22 and Juice is like around the same age as me. I definitely feel like people in our age group and generation understand anxiety more. I definitely think it's a lot more prevalent in today's day and age than it was back in the day. I really like what he had to say there. Next song is called Not Enough.
Now I've been drowning in this liquor bottle, but drowning's not enough. They tell me that I won't live to see tomorrow, but I don't give a fuck. I'm running out of patience, out of pleasure, and running out of luck. I'm really scared that we won't stay together. What if you run out of your love? You run out of your love. I hope you know if I said it, baby, I'm intact. Straight lovers, we ain't going to a friendship. Fail for you, I don't know how it happened. When we kiss and I taste all the passion. Time worth more than money, but I'll spend. And I'll evade on you, me, you into the end. No talking, baby, I'm about to action. All these other hoes are so irrelevant. And I next, you talk. Now I've been drowning in this liquor bottle, but drowning's not enough. They tell me that I won't ever see tomorrow, but I don't give a fuck. I'm running out of patience, out of pleasure, and running out of luck. I'm really scared that we won't stay together. What if you run out of your love? You run out of your love.
I like that one a lot. It definitely has like more of an upbeat feel with just the beat on it, but obviously the lyrics are still like that realness and that genuineness that Juice WRLD gives you. This song just gives me a different type of feel than the other songs and makes me happy. The next song here is called Feline with Polo G and Trippie Redd.
Got a new nine that'll leave your mouth wide. Leave you hog tied, burning on a campfire. Before I leave the crib, I pray to God I won't die. I know it's hard to kill me, but I know they gon' try. You's a pussy boy, yeah, you a feline. Get your own business and get out mine. Had to kill a witness.
demons ain't doing no time. Watch them niggas around you, they playing both sides. Well, your gang, get your homies, not your homies. Run it up, get that sack, but do that shit right by your lonely. Chop a hit up with a force like on Obi-Wan Kenobi. Don't need no court to use my torch, I've been shooting like on Kobe.
I feel like that pain put anger in your heart, you wanna kill them all. I lost my nigga from the start, I hate I miss his call. If you stay low, you play your part, then you gon' get to ball. Fast lane, we never going park, I just keep drifting on.
Do what you used to, I was raised up, heartless, I'm a loose screw. I'ma get all up in your head and seduce you.
Chillin' with some niggas in the back that'll shoot at you.
Yeah, ready, set, aim. I'ma blow your damn brain. If I about the car, shoot the bitch at close range. We ain't playing both sides. Tell me with me, 4-5. Just go right to nine. 1-800-999.
That'll leave your mouth wide. Leave you hog tied, burning on a campfire.
I do like it. I think it's catchy. I think it's a good song. But I like the other songs. I felt like they made me feel a little bit more than this one. Next song we have is called Relocate.
He did a lot of really nice, generous things for me. Like, he bought me a house, you know, cars, and paid off my student loans, and, you know, all kinds of stuff. And he just be like, okay, he didn't care. He just didn't care about stuff like that. When he came to see the house, he was like, oh, this is like the places you used to take me. I'm glad you like your house.
Get it on my own, I'm gonna do my own thing. Mama and the man just had to relocate. Remember playing hide and seek in the crawl space. Now I can play it in the 16 room by the lake. Real estate is an investment, houses in the hay. Tryna block me from my blessing. Get shot in the face with a 40 Smith and Wesson. I'm a fool with the hay. Hanging out the window screaming gang, gang.
The beginning of the song is super heartfelt to have his mom in there and her just talking about what he has done for her. I think that's super amazing that he wanted to and was willing to give back to his mom. I feel like everyone that knew and talked about Juice always spoke so highly of him and talked about how like giving and caring he was, and especially for the women in his life. Like, he was always very open about the love he had for his mom, for his girlfriend Allie, and I think that's just a beautiful thing to see. Next track is called Juice WRLD Speaks 2.
I remember that Mamba put a gun out there, get the stumble and tumble. And the chopper get the thunder. Shitting on all these haters, like, what a plunge at. I'm excited. Cause now I can throw a party and all the people that hated on me won't be invited. True religion on me like the Buddha. Indian style, I'm enlightened. I remember up in kindergarten, my teacher told me I wouldn't be shit. And then she saw me play the piano and made all the other kids seasick.
What I'm getting with this track is this is definitely one of Juice's freestyles that he's done. He's definitely one of the best freestylers that I've ever heard. I know there's been like videos of him like freestyling for like hours on end. Honestly, just insane. That's like pure talent right there. Probably one of my favorite lines from this freestyle is, I gotta admit myself, I'm on these drugs, feel like I can't save myself. Sometimes I want to take myself and break myself so I can reshape myself. Nobody ever felt the pain I felt, so I share it, put it out to the world, I ain't embarrassed. I especially like that ending part of that verse because I think a lot of people are embarrassed to feel feelings and share their emotions and share their pain. I know for the longest time I was embarrassed of my emotions, and still to this day sometimes they're hard to face. There's a lot of beauty in vulnerability, and he wouldn't be the artist he is if he wasn't able to be vulnerable with his music. Next song we have is Until the Plug Comes Back Around.
It goes down, down, down when the plug is in town. Prescriptions fill them out, pills get passed around. Run, 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 run away from my pain now. I feel like passing out. Why do I feel irrational? Running out of pills, now it's time to ration out. Until the plug come back around. Until the plug come back around.
Everybody got their demons, everybody got their vices. Everybody got their own opinion on what life is. I should have had you feeling lifeless.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 100. I was just counting my sins. Everywhere I go, I see where to begin? Every morning on my knees praying to God that we win. Fuck it, let's win it then. I got rich on my mama crib. How much are you willing to spend? This money don't mean shit, but I still put them diamonds on my wrist. Let's make niggas see shit. But lately I've been on my D shit. And that life is a mountain, niggas don't know how steep it is.
On this one, I really like where he says everybody got their own opinion on what life is. Ain't that the damn truth? Life has a lot of different meanings for a lot of different people. Still working on what I see life as. Next song is called From My Window.
Ecstasy, taking rock star steez.
I like that.
Ecstasy, taking rock star steez. Make a bad bitch get on her knees. Ask cause she suck my tuck, yes please. Put it in the throat, shorty choked and sneezed. I see the world from my window. I ain't going outside, see it through my window. Money from the record label, spend it all on ammo. Living in paranoia, got me living like I'm Rambo. Life is a TV show, if you try me, it'll be canceled. Three stick users like a IV hospital. My wifey fucked me off of the whitey Malcolm middle. Put it in her mouth, juice world popsicle. I'm
the verses on this song are kind of funny. Some of the verses are a little interesting. I like the chorus. Definitely like the melody of the song as well. This one, just the lyrics, made me laugh a little bit. Next song we have is Girl of My Dreams with Suga of BTS. I'm not very familiar with BTS at all, so this will be kind of like a first impression for me.
Girl in my dreams, man, I ain't falling asleep. Think both of your legs going away, you falling for me. The same way that the rain falls. I ain't gonna lie, you got it all in me. Love's all to you, like I'm John Legend. Some better save some room for my heart. It's a big one, I'ma give it to you. Ain't no better mood than you. Really help me find my groove. Fake hoes coming.
Obviously, I have no clue what his verse said. His voice sounded good though, but I'm not even gonna say anything because I have not a damn clue what he said. And even the Genius lyrics are not in English, so. What I will say is, oh my god, this song brings out the inner simp in me that I try so hard to keep buried in there. I think it's so cute how dedicated and how like in love and obsessed Juice is with Ali. I just think his love for her was amazing, honestly. Next song we have is Feel Alone.
Stuck in my mind, oh yeah, I'm in my prime, oh yeah, taking my time, oh yeah, even though everything feels so fast, losing my mind, but it's okay, it's fine, I'ma just keep getting high, yeah, I'm trying to reach new heights. The signs when I feel alone. There's times when I feel alone. There's times when I feel alone. There's times when I feel alone. I wonder if anybody knows. I wonder if anybody notices. When I get in my head and feel alone. No, I don't think nobody really notices. Life don't seem so fair. That was standing right there. Funny, you don't think I see you standing right there. I guess I'm just too high to care.
Every song on this album just has such emotion. I feel like this is a prime example of why people relate to Juice's music so well. He never holds back, he puts it all on the table. Last song on the album is My Life in a Nutshell.
This is my life in a nutshell. Heaven so far. For my talent, but don't know how my name feels. These prescriptions that I feel never make the pain heal. Back in the lost and found, I go, but I'm more lost and found. I know I feel so cold in LA, like I'm sitting back at home. Chicago, they say living's harder than dying. Responsive in a hotel room, girl, can you handle that? Worst case scenario. You still hear my songs on the stereo. You still hear my name on the radio. So I'll live forever, forever. This is my life in a nutshell.
I have chills all over my body from this song. It's heartbreaking to say the least. It's pretty insane because he practically damn near predicted his own death. These lyrics are pretty much word for word what the current situation is. Worst case scenario, you'll still hear my songs on the stereo. You'll still hear my name on the radio, so I'll live forever, forever. It's very apparent that he was looking for help, seeking help. His lyrics are practically like a cry out for help. This is honestly like a really tough way to end the album. I honestly want to cry after listening to this song. I really don't even know how to like recap my feelings on this project because there's just so much to say and so much pain and beauty in this album at the same time. He put so much emotion and pain into his music, and with that he helped millions, so many people, but unfortunately he was not able to help himself. I know before he passed he did have plans of getting help. It's just unfortunate that he was not able to do so before his passing. I think losing Juice was a huge loss for the rap community as a whole. He is one of the most influential artists of our generation, and it's just sad that he is gone so soon when his impact could have been much, much, much greater than what it is now. This getting released was a great way to end out the year. I think this will definitely probably be one of my favorite projects of the year because even just off the first initial listen, I loved every single song. It made me feel a lot of things that a lot of other albums haven't made me feel this year, so for that I'm very appreciative. You guys definitely have to let me know what you thought of the album as a whole down below in the comments. That is pretty much it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.